I think scrutiny is normal. I mean, football for too long time for not to be surprised with scrutinies and for not to be surprised with opinions and critics and anything else. I'm not surprised. I'm not worried. I didn't read many, but for sure I have to agree with some. For sure, and I have to disagree with some others for sure. But I have a job to do, and I know where I want to go, and I know the steps I have to give, and I also know that when you want to build something different than the players are adapted and the players are comfortable and has been the philosophy for years is more difficult. The easiest thing for a new manager is to arrive in a club and not to change and go in the same direction or to be even in a better situation, which is keep something and buy a couple of players better than what you had previously, but go in the same direction. Everything is mechanic. The dynamic is known by everybody. If you want to do something different, there is a period where I understand that if the results are not good, people put some question marks in the direction you go. But it's up to me to follow the direction or not to follow. If somebody expect me to play against Fulham because we need to win, we need the victory. But if somebody expecting me to play against Fulham with a low block, nine players behind the ball line, waiting for Fulham to make a mistake, to score a goal in a counter-attack and to go home with 3 points, very, very happy. I'm not going in that direction.
Say you agree with some of the scrutiny. What bits do you agree with? What bits have been
I didn't
clarified?
read. I didn't read, but I can guess that I have to agree with some. I have to agree with some critics. I have to agree with some opinions. That's obvious. That's obviously. And but I didn't read to be fair. But I have to say that I accept. Opinions and I accept critics, and as I was saying, for sure I will disagree with some, but for sure I will agree with some others.
Is it a surprise to see the team where they're at the moment, based on what you're seeing on the training ground and what you saw in pre-season? Is it surprising?
Look, the first thing I have to say is that we lost nothing, and you like scrutinies and you like to compare things. And we didn't finish third in the Champions League group. We didn't go relegated to the Europa League. And we didn't finish third in the Premier League. We lost one match in the Premier League. The other five contenders to the title. All of them lost a match, except Liverpool that goes top of the league. And in the Champions League, we lost a match that we cannot lose. I agree completely that we cannot lose that match. But we were not relegated to the Europa League. So if you like scrutinies, if you like to make comparisons, you have to wait. You have to wait because this is not the way you start, it's the way you finish. You want to start good, go good, and finish good. That's the perfect picture. But between start bad and finish well, or start well and finish bad, I prefer to start bad and finish well. But I agree, the perfect situation is to start well, to go well. And to finish well, I agree.